Hey everyone, I hope your week is wrapping up productive and you're getting ready for a good weekend with the people closest to you. Hopefully you're more acclimated to the social distancing and in staying in our homes more than we were last week. I think day by day we're probably learning on how to cope with this and strategize more to make it through productively. This is about the fourth or fifth time I'm trying to record this. And I'm getting a little frustrated, so hopefully it works this time. The sun is not cooperating. The lighting kind of sucks. So I'm hoping this works. But resiliency, right? And on that topic of resiliency, three things that are really important, I think, to continue to develop resiliency that we need to be more aware of is our self-awareness, our self-management, and empathy, all right? So when I'm talking about self-awareness, it's continuing to learn about ourselves, and we have opportunities to do that all the time. And we tend to learn the most about ourselves during trying times, challenging situations, adversity. As much as I hate to admit that, as much as I hate those learning experiences, it tends to happen if we are open to that. So for a lot of people, these are trying times. I had a conversation with a buddy today who is still required to come into work. That's concerning for him and his wife. That's frustrating for him. She is also required to go into work as a medical professional. That raises all kinds of concerns, right? So we're all trying to figure out how to get through this, and how do we do it? We do it through self-awareness, learning about ourselves, understanding how the world's impacting us, what's creating the stress, what's creating this frustration, what's raising our insecurities, but more importantly, what happens next? What is it influencing us to do? How are we treating other people? Is it setting us up for success? That's where that self-management comes in, okay? So each of us has good and bad and ugly. Each of us has things about ourselves that are really positive that will contribute to success, a higher quality experience for ourselves and others, contribute to the greater good. We each have things about us that are not as positive that won't set us up for success, that won't help us maintain productive relationships with other people, that won't contribute to the greater good. And it's up to us through our self-awareness to understand our good and bad and ugly. Let's maximize the things about us that are really positive so we continue to have positive experiences and success, so we can continue to cope and strategize productively. And how do we manage all the stuff that doesn't set us up for success? Well, we're never going to have the opportunity to manage it if we don't acknowledge them, admit them, and try to be intentional about working on them. Okay? So I believe through self-management, we can create kind of a baseline of security or steadiness to where we don't have to allow the world around us to trigger us to respond to things all the time, especially if it's not setting us up for success. And that leads me into empathy. Lots of people are in uncomfortable situations right now. Lots of people are frustrated, stressed out. Their tension is up. Insecurities are triggered because of the current environment we're in, because of situations that are happening close to them. Well, if you're frustrated and you're insecure or you're experiencing challenges, it's probably fair to assume that other people are as well. It's probably fair to assume that the people closest to us are as well. So how do we look at people? How do we see people more objectively, not take things as personally, and really deploy empathy in these trying times? How do we become more understanding? How do we give people more grace, right? How do we suspend judgment and frustration empathetically, and send us up for to be able to support the people around us, even though it might be challenging, even though it might be frustrated? And I know different people are dealing with different things and different levels of things, and I totally get that as well. My biggest fear with all of this is that these trying times lead people to do things out of character or behave in ways that create conflict or stressors around them that may lead to bigger challenges, right? So resiliency is really important here. Self-awareness, self-management, empathy for those around us are really important in times like this.